If you're ever on a date with someone and they're quite boring, what you do is you just, if you sit at a table or something, you know, you just slowly inch your seat away. It's very, very slowly, inch by inch, until you're back home again.
Well, that would be a very unexpected episode of First Dates. Would you please welcome Melanie Bracewell?
Tom just told me to put my seat down a little bit, and I think his masculinity was a little bit.
No,
he's like, can you just go down?
It's something they tell you to do.
Okay, all right. That makes me feel
gone red.
Tom makes everyone put their seat down so that he looks taller.
Yeah,
like we spend 15 minutes before the show every night.
That's not what happened.
So how is the dating game going?
Oh, it's terrible because I now have a long-term boyfriend and he's killed a lot of my material.
Oh, no.
It's sickening. I know. It's awful. My show's nothing. No, he's lovely. We went to school together and he's come to Australia with me. And I... to describe him, he's kind of like a nerdy little loser, but I love him. He's wonderful. But to kind of explain what he's like we got here and I saw him searching on his phone the phrase Australian singles, and I was like, what is this a-hole up to? Like, what's he doing?
Yeah.
And I pried. I was like, what are you looking at? And he went, oh, I'm trying to find a website in which I can buy single Yu-Gi-Oh cards online. And I was like, that's so much worse. Like,
no, Yu-Gi-Oh is amazing.
It's amazing. You're a Yu-Gi-Oh fan?
Yeah, I am. Yeah. Your boyfriend up with yeah, we get
it. I'd be like, Yu-Gi-Oh back to the singles bar. Yeah. I'm gonna stay here.
Exactly.
Yeah. Hey, Mel, the Melbourne International Comedy Festival is coming up. Everyone's very excited about that. Your last show was an absolute hit. Does that come with, like, added pressure now?
Yeah.
For the next shows to come?
Yes. I think I'm kind of channeling Tom where I want that show to sort of get smaller and smaller in people's minds so that I can look better this next time.
Yeah.
But I am very excited in my show. I won an award last year, so that's a...
Congratulations.
Yeah, congrats. Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Like, sell your show. Yeah. About, like,
was it the award for the meanest to the guy sitting next to you?
I'm sorry, it was too funny.
It was a director's choice.
I won director's choice, which was very cool. But the problem was, at the same time as the award ceremony, I had a netball game for the South Yarra Netball Club.
Oh.
And I had to leave the game half time, and then I, like, arrived in my netball uniform and I had to accept the award in my dress.
Oh.
I don't know if there's that, so that's yes.
there,
so the errors. So
position?
I had
goal attack.
Goal keep.
Oh,
yeah.
Good. That's the better one.
And then in my speech, I had to sort of do a sort of post match, sort of, oh, full credit to the boys. thanks so much. you know. But this is me. Now that you guys mocked me for bringing up my award, I brought a different award.
Oh!
Because I also. No biggie, but also got best and fairest.
Oh,
at the South
yes.
Yarra Netball
Club.
Thank
you.
There's no story behind that. I just wanted to bring it up.
Between being tall in a chair and your two awards, you're really making Tom feel pretty small tonight.
All he's got is that he's not a robot.
I'm the fairest, but not in the way that that award means. Just in terms of my complexion.
Hey, the last time, well, since we got to see you last time, you're now an absolute superstar and host of The Cheap Seats. How did that all come about?
Well, basically, Channel 10 were like, we've run out of NCIS, please, we need something. And when the opportunity arised as a New Zealander to come to Australia and steal your jobs, I was like, yes, absolutely. But it's been amazing. It's been such a cool show. I feel like I know you very well, Georgie, because I just watch you on the
clips.
Watch you on the news all the time, and I feel like I've formed all these, like, parasocial relationships.
Oh, yes.
Like,
that's a
I
thing.
Feel like me and Koshy are mates. Like,
yeah.
I just watch him every morning and like in, like, 2x speed, which is, like, insane because he's already so high energy. So it's been pretty cool. It's amazing. It's really cool.
Is The Cheap Seats coming back?
It is coming back. It's coming back.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wow.
So much to celebrate in your life.
Yeah, so much. And there's going to be more soon as well because you have a new show, Ooh La La, which is going to be touring around the country, and tickets are on sale now, I think, as well. So head to our website for more details. Mel Bracewell, thank you so much for joining us.